Hey everybody, this is Carissa and welcome back to my YouTube channel, Inky Fairy Designs. I know it's been a hot minute, but I am back for Mixed Media Monday and I'm going to show you how I created this face on a pre-printed background. I started this process actually when I created the background and I really wanted to put a face on it, but it was giving me so much grief and so much headache and I was super frustrated, so I set it aside for a couple of weeks. And this past weekend I thought I really want to pull that out and try to fix that face or create a girl on here, and so that's what I'm doing. I started with a few shades of Jane Davenport's acrylic paints, and it took a couple of coats, probably two or three coats. I dried it in between and added a new coat until all of that previous drawing was covered up and I just had this blank slate again. So I kind of just blocked out my background with this face feature. Now I'm going in with some scribble sticks and I am sketching out my guidelines, and now I'm starting to sketch out the features. And I love using scribble sticks for this because, first of all, they're water soluble. Secondly, there's so many colors. I can start with a really light color and then build up as I'm happy with it. I'll go in with a darker color and start to finish up those details, add more to it. I can move things at this point and it doesn't matter. The guidelines don't even show up in the end. So it's one of my favorite ways to sketch out these mixed media girls. And after I'm done with the blue, I will come in with a black Stabilo-All and add even more definition to the features. So that's how I start sketching, and already she's looking so much better than the first one. I am so happy with it, and it's just really fun and awesome to really see the girl come to life and what she ends up looking like in the end. This is something that I'm not super confident in, but I am trying to push myself to do more because it's something that I really want to do. And if I really want to do it, I just have to try it and keep practicing and each time get a little bit better. So while I'm finishing up some of those features on the face, I wanted to talk a bit about the background and how you can learn how I created it. It's not going to be on my YouTube channel. I am actually part of a course called the Savvy Supply School, which is part of Mixed Up Creative Academy, and it's all about thinking outside the box with your crafting materials and using found items around the house, easily found items that you can then use in your art. So it's an amazing course with 26 supply savvy mixed media lessons. There's 22 artists altogether that are participating and sharing their knowledge with you. And I just wanted to let you guys know that signups are happening right now, and until November 30th, I have a special discount code for you. It's 20% off of the price, so you would only pay $56 if you sign up before November 30th, and the class starts January 3rd. So if you want to find out more about that and you like the background that I created and you want to know how I did it, I'm not going to give you any hints, except that I use a jelly plate and something really cool that everybody has access to. So check that out in the description box, sign up, use my code and get that 20% off. And I hope to see you in class because it's going to be awesome. All right. So now I am blocking out her hair. I pulled out some different acrylics. All of the supplies will be listed in the description box below. I'm using a combination of DecoArt, Americana, and Pebeo Studio acrylics. These are all just paints that I kept out. I am actually working with a limited supply myself. Right now, I am in the process of selling our house, moving, and when we started getting the house ready to put on the market, we staged it. So I had to get rid of or pack away a lot of my supplies, but it's been really nice because working with limited amount of supplies, I feel like I don't have that overwhelming sense of what do I use first? So I have like a little tote or a little basket of paints, and that's what I am using. I kept out DecoArt and of course my Dina Wakley, and then some of my favorites that haven't been used because, like I said, when you have too much, it's like, where do I start? So it's been really nice working with a limited supply, and it's going to become even more limited in the near future. So after I was happy with her hair, I'm going in and I'm starting to add some color and definition depth to her face before I go all out and use a permanent medium to outline her features. So I'm using a combination of like the Scribble sticks with a water brush, and then I'll bring in some Jane Davenport Mermaid markers, which I really don't know if you can still find them. I got them at Michael's and such. I think I do have a link to them in the description below at Amazon. You can still find them. But if you aren't finding them and you want to work with something similar, I know Vicky Bouton, I don't know if that's how you say her last name, is also with American Crafts and has her own line of watermarkers or watercolor markers that look very similar to these. They look like they're in the same packaging and everything. So I would assume that those will work just as well. So now I am taking a leap, being brave, and I am outlining everything with a permanent medium. This is the Jane Davenport Hot Vinyl Pen in gloss. So it's a black permanent marker and it has a brush tip. And I'm using it to outline her features. I wouldn't say I love this pen. It actually, right as I was doing the eyelashes, it globbed up and dropped a quite amount of medium onto my project. And I was almost freaking out because I thought, oh gosh, I just ruined this whole thing. I sopped up most of it with a baby wipe and was able to salvage it. And while I'm not like super happy with the way her eyelashes came out, they're decent and I enjoy the overall piece. So I don't know. I got to work with this a little bit more. The other one that I had, which I got, I got them. I don't know if they're sold in a pack or sold separately, but I got them at the same time, was totally dried out, and I could have left the cap off, or one of my kids could have left the cap off. I don't know, but it was totally dried out. The other one is a matte, which I would have preferred. But like I said, it was dried out when I went to use it. So the gloss is what I had. That's what I used. And if you guys have any suggestions on what you like to like draw with over paint, if you do mixed media girls, and you know, you have a favorite marker or pen or something that you use for like these details, I would love to know in the description box. So leave me a comment, a link, or whatever. I will check it out because I'm still looking for my favorite. So I'm just kind of experimenting. These I've just had. So one of the reasons I love to use water-soluble stuff over the acrylic is because of right here. I didn't like the way her cheeks looked. I didn't like that color. So I'm able to use a baby wipe and just wipe it clean and then go in with something else and try something different. So I will fuss around with the coloring of this girl for a bit, going back and forth between the Scribble sticks and the mermaid markers until I'm happy with the result. So how I learned how to draw faces, because I know a lot of people ask, I don't think I am qualified. I just like to show you like my process and how I work through things. Like, I think my channel is more of showing you how to get from one point to another, how to push past the ugly, which I say all the time, which you guys saw in the very beginning. I had to push past that very ugly piece, and sometimes it takes me a couple of weeks to push past it, but you can push past it, and that's what I think I bring to mixed media. But how I learned to draw faces, Dina Wakely, of course, I took a class from her. I have her books and I just love her style. So Dina Wakely is a huge inspiration to me. Jane Davenport, again, I have her books, and I have started a couple of her online courses in the past. So she's a huge influence to me. And then another one, which you don't really see a lot in the mixed media, but Danielle Donaldson. I just love her watercoloring and I love her drawing. So those are like my huge inspirations for drawing. Also, my friend Jamie Doherty. I've taken her classes, and she's also another huge one who's inspired me and taught me pretty much what I know. And I think for once, or for after a few years, I'm finally kind of seeing my own style come out, and I feel more comfortable and confident sharing that here. So I'm excited to share more with you. So now the last thing that I'm going to do for this piece is just add a bit of journaling around her hair. I love that look. And then, to go along with her journaling, which is really just kind of random stuff, I add a little heart, because that's the intention behind the journaling, is just to love yourself and, know who you are. So that's kind of what this piece represents. So if that resonates with you, or you like the way that this turned out and you want to purchase this original piece, it is going to be for sale in my family's Etsy store. I will have a link to that in the description box. Check it out. My kids have some awesome stuff there that they have created that you can check out as well. And I'm going to start putting more of my artwork up there. So bookmark it, check it out. Definitely going to have some Christmas cards in there. So thank you always for your support. Thank you for your comments, and thank you for subscribing to my channel. I appreciate all of you. If you're new to this channel and you like what you've seen, I would love it if you also subscribed and click on the bell notifications. I have a lot of stuff coming out to you before the end of the year. Wednesday, I will have a new mixed media piece for you up here on my channel, as well as Sean Petit's channel. And I am working on my 12 days of Creative Christmas, and can't wait to start sharing that with you on December 1st as well. So thank you again for watching. If you have any questions about anything that you've seen in this video, definitely leave me a comment, let me know, and I will get back to you as soon as I can. Until next time, stay inspired, guys. Be creative and share that with others, because that's what it's all about. Bye.